Okay, so this question revolves around a vapor liquid equilibrium question. And here we have a cyclohexane water type system that is in equilibrium at 50 degrees C, and it contains two liquid phases, one that's rich in cyclohexane, the other that's rich in water, and that's in equilibrium with a vapor phase. At constant pressure, we're going to decrease the temperature to 45 degrees C. And basically, the question is what happens to the different phases in this system? And we'll look at two ways of looking at this. All right, one is that we can simply apply the Gibb's phase rule. It says that the number of degrees of freedom is equal to 2 plus the number of components minus the number of phases. And so if we have 2 plus 2 minus 3 here, so we have two components, which are cyclohexane and water, and we have three phases, which are two liquids and one vapor. And so that gives us 1 degree of freedom. And so if we fix the pressure, that's our degree of freedom, and there will be one and only one temperature at which there will be these three phases, the two liquid phases and a vapor phase. So we've fixed the pressure, and so there's only one temperature at which we'll have the three phases, and that temperature is 50 degrees C. And so if we decrease the temperature to 45 degrees C, then we'll no longer have all of those phases. So we're going to expect to have a decrease in the number of phases in order to satisfy the Gibb's phase rule. If we're decreasing the temperature as we are here, then we're going to expect to condense the vapor, right, at fixed pressure. So the phase that we lose, we would expect would be the vapor. And so that brings us to the other way of trying to analyze this. Okay, and so I've made just a phase diagram pop up here. And so we see that we have phases that correspond to two different liquid phases, alpha and beta, and a vapor. And initially, we're at vapor liquid equilibrium, right, which means that we're along this line somewhere. Right, so along this line corresponds to vapor liquid equilibrium. And recall that this phase diagram is at a fixed pressure. So there's only one and only one temperature, as we've just said. That's at 50 degrees C at this pressure, at which we'll have the three phases corresponding to that line. And so any decrease in the temperature when we're along this line will bring us into the two liquid phase region. So we can analyze this using either the Gibb's phase rule or a simple sketch of a phase equilibrium plot of temperature versus composition.